So I am on this web page. You can click on the link given in the description to download the data. So if you click, you will get to this page. You can just click on the download button to download the data. I've already downloaded it. You will get an archive version of the data. Just click on it so to unzip it, and you will get a folder named data. So I have this folder named data. I'll just open it and I can see all the text. So name of the files are federalist_1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. These are the files which have been written by some of the authors, and our key idea is to understand their style of writing so that we can get some idea how we can distinguish different authors using their style of writing. So our analysis will use these files as input, and we'll plot the word length distribution, and through that we'll try to make some sense that whether different people write in a different way or not. So these are key idea, and these are input file. Please download it, please see it once, and let's start with the code. So we are splitting the papers into 5 categories. So these categories are these files, for example, are we are going to split categorize these files into 5 categories. First, there are 51 papers known to have been written by Alexander Hamilton, and there are in these files there are 14 papers to have been written by James Madison. 4 of the 5 papers are known to have been written by John Jay, and 3 papers were co-written by Madison and Hamilton. And there are 12 papers disputed between Hamilton and Madison, which we don't know who exactly was the author of these 12 papers. So our idea is to understand the style of writing of these papers and then try to analyze these 12 papers, whether they were written by Hamilton or Madison. So we will use our key idea, which we discussed in previous videos, that we'll try to plot the word distribution, I mean word length distribution. And with this, we'll try to see whether is it really that people have different way of writing. People have different way of writing papers such that they use different length of words differently. So in next video, we'll try to write a code for this, and we'll plot the graph of this word length distribution, and we'll try to analyze the data. Thank you.